In the screenplay, after the clock lady moves along, they move closer for that kiss. But Doc Brown is introduced and pulls up in a medium-sized RV, yelling for Marty through his loudspeaker PA system, ruining their tender moment. The RV is towing a trailer with a tarp vehicle. I wonder what that could be.
Jennifer and Marty enter.
Doc's described as an old hippie with shoulder-length white hair, Hawaiian shirt, faded jeans, and Indian turquoise around his neck, and lively, almost wild eyes. Einstein is in the RV, along with a bunch of clocks that are, of course, dead sync, AV equipment, a monitor tuned to MTV, a huge mess, and a lead canister with purple radiation symbols on it. His RV is a lot like the garage in the movie. They must have had traded the RV for the garage, as well as the 84 GMC van he keeps the DeLorean in at the mall. Doc reminds Marty about tonight's experiment and wants him to be at the mall at 1 a.m. When Marty asks what are they doing at 1 a.m., Doc doesn't want to spoil it. Marty says, "You're not planning on breaking into another power plant or something. That was kind of risky." And Doc responds, "That's the point, Marty. Risk. Risk makes life worth living. What would you rather do? Sleep?" Doc checks one of his four watches on his arm. "It's almost time. Quiet." Susie gives Marty a bewildered look, but Marty knows what's about to happen. It's exactly 4 o'clock and all the clocks chime at once. Dings, dongs, electric tones, cuckoo birds. Doc loves it. He drinks it up like a proud father, saying, "I love that." Marty and Susie step out of the RV. Susie's not really approving of Doc like Jennifer is in the final film.
It's like Doc's
saying. Yeah, I know. If you put your mind to it, you can accomplish anything.
Which is a line they never use in the screenplay. Marty tells Susie that Doc's alright, and tells her how they first met. In the screenplay, Marty first meets Doc when he shows up at his door and asks him to clean his garage. He paid him $50 a week with beer.
White beer?
And access to his record collection. I'm glad they didn't use this. If Marty's dialogue was kept in, it would just be a spiel of exposition. Show, not tell. I've always thought that keeping how they met ambiguous was a smart move. Plus, most people already know back in 2011, co-writer-producer Bob Gale canonized the story by saying, "Okay, from the horse's mouth. Yes, I'm the horse-er. Co-writer, co-creator." We never explained it in the movie, but the history of the characters that Bob Zemeckis and I created is this. For years, Marty was told that Doc Brown was dangerous, a crackpot, a lunatic. So being a red-blooded American teenage boy, age 13 or 14, he decided to find out just why this guy was so dangerous. Marty snuck into Doc's lab, and he was fascinated by all the cool stuff that was there. When Doc found him there, he was delighted to find that Marty thought he was cool and accepted him for what he was. Both of them were black sheep in their respective environments. Doc gave Marty a part-time job to help with experiments, tend to the lab, tend to the dog, etc. And that's the origin of their relationship. And if you want more details about that story, Bob Gale and IDW Comics got together and released Back to the Future, Untold Tales and Alternate Timelines. The very first story is called When Marty Met Emmett. It goes into all the juicy details. The first issue came out on Back to the Future Day.
On Wednesday, October 21st, 2015.
Before we officially knew how they met, it never really mattered. At least to me, it didn't. I felt that most people just accepted their friendship. And maybe all the theories are right in their own way. In their own alternate timeline. Like maybe in the original 1985 A timeline, Doc did come to Marty's house asking to clean his garage. But in the new timeline where Marty has a 4x4 and his family is cool, 1985 B, Marty does sneak into Doc's lab. Because with the 1955 Doc knowing what he knows about his future, that would amplify his behavior, which would get the attention of a red-blooded American teenage boy, thereby having Marty sneak into his lab, and now that's how they meet.